Tere. Hello.
Hello.
So we have also some journalists here.
Tere tulemast. Nii alustame pressikonverentsiga.
Good morning. Let's start with the press conference.
Nii palju siin on.
I'm glad to see so many of you here. Please find a seat. If you see an English speaking colleague who has not yet received a headset, then direct them towards the corner. The first speaker will be Estonian Minister of Entrepreneurship and IT of Estonia, Urve Palo. Good afternoon. Ladies and gentlemen, this morning, 32 EU and EFTA member states signed the Tallinn Declaration on eGovernment, which has as a purpose to reinvigorate this field in the whole Europe. So everybody who was present, the 32 member states have signed this declaration. With this declaration, we have jointly agreed on the next steps concerning the field of e-government, and these should be taken both on the EU level as well as on national levels within the next 5 years. Our country is often called e-Estonia because most daily transactions can be carried out digitally, both in the public sector as well as elsewhere. E-solutions have not been so widely adopted everywhere in Europe, especially in the public sector. And today we have agreed that developing e-government in member states and in the EU is of key importance to ensure that we can fulfill the opportunities offered by new technologies. Adopting new e-government solutions and developing the field further will contribute to the growth of data-based economy and in creating the digital single market. In addition, digital solutions will help increase the transparency of public services. That also means decreasing corruption. It is more difficult to do something undercover. So we will have increased transparency, speed, reliability, and of course efficiency. So we will save time for both citizens and businesses. This is why we agreed that within the next 5 years, we will jointly take steps towards a more integral e-government in the EU, based on a number of principles which are already familiar in Estonia, and a few examples of those principles. Creating possibilities for citizens and companies to communicate with state administrations digitally. Secondly, once-only principle, at least as an option and at least considering all the basic data. This means that a state should not ask citizens or businesses to resubmit data that they have already submitted to the state once. So basically, we want to achieve that all member states follow the once-only principles. And once we have achieved this on national level, then we can also achieve this on the EU level. So we could have an Estonian citizen traveling to Finland or Sweden or Denmark. Those states could operate on the data retrieved by the state of Estonia on that citizen, but we should start at home first. The next principle would be adoption of national electronic ID schemes in a way that would also enable mutual recognition of electronic IDs within the EU. Because if this would not be the case, we couldn't be talking about cross-border data exchange. So in the future, that would mean, for example, cross-border digital prescriptions for medicines or digital signatures. In Estonia, we are saving about 2% of our GDP through digital signing every year, and this is an opportunity for the whole of Europe. And in the afternoon, Our high-level digital services conference will go on. Ministers and participants of our ministerial session will participate this afternoon as well. And there I will digitally sign the talent declaration, which other parties have already signed in a physical form, and I hope that our next joint declaration will already be digitally signed by all the parties. Thank you. And now, Vice President of the European Commission, Andrus Ansip.
Thank you. Not just thanking you for giving me the floor, but I would truly like to thank everyone who worked hard during the previous week on carrying out this digital meeting, and who have been also working during this week. I would like to thank you for organizing numerous meetings. We have had a very fruitful week in the digital sense for the whole of Europe. There are people dealing with the e-governance issues. We have the chief information officers here. They have had a very busy agenda here in Tallinn. Yesterday we had a meeting with the Eastern Partnership ministers. We discussed cooperation in the digital field. And today, as of the morning, we have already been discussing the issues of e-governance. I'm not really neutral in this, but I dare say that this has been very well organized. I have taken part in numerous meetings, ministerial meetings, European Union summits, and I dare say that the organization of the meetings here in Estonia is exemplary. Thank you for everything. Well, I don't think this is a topic for the press conference, but last time I was here, I was truly amazed. I was amazed that I could get from here to the airport in 5 minutes. During my 9 years as the Prime Minister of the Republic and later as the Commissioner, I never have experienced this, that I can get from a venue to the airport in just 5 minutes. And here in Tallinn, it is possible. It takes just 5 minutes to reach the airport. I'm grateful to the member states for signing the Tallinn e-government declaration. Minister Urve Palo already gave a thorough description of what this declaration is about. We all know that the solutions of e-government are usually much more efficient than the traditional paper-based solutions and decisions. It helps us to save resources by using these e-solutions. And it's not just about Europe, it's also about elsewhere in Europe. We know that in India, citizens were provided with electronic IDs, and thanks to this, that they didn't need any intermediaries anymore when citizens were paid allowances, they saved $8 billion each year. In Nigeria, they introduced a data exchange system which allowed to exchange data between citizens and public services. So 63,000 people were discovered by this who actually didn't work at all but were in this register, and it helped to save $1 billion a year. So such cost efficiency is possible elsewhere, so why shouldn't it be possible in Europe? Let's take Sweden, for example. They introduced the system of e-procurement. And now Sweden says that it helped them save up to 20% in some sectors due to these e-procurements. In Portugal, the e-procurement system was introduced in hospitals. And this provided this cost saving of 18%. So e-solutions, as a rule, are always more efficient than the traditional solutions. And the solutions of e-government are usually also much more transparent than the solutions that are paper-based. And once the solutions are transparent, then it makes the citizens happy, it makes the businesses happy. But those who are corrupt of course, are not happy. But not everyone always has to be happy, right? E-solutions are always more inclusive than the old traditional solutions. When people are informed, then they would also like to take more part in various processes, also the decision-making processes. And with this declaration, we state that all the solutions offered by the government must be digital, all the data must be public, must be available for everyone to use. In addition to that, all the solutions nowadays must also be cross-border. It is not sufficient when people within one country can make full use of these good solutions. The once-only principle must work all over Europe, must work cross-border. Once a person has submitted certain data to, let's say, the business register, and now in another country wants to take part in a public procurement, then why should that person once again print out this data from the first register, get the stamps and the seals, and then transport them physically to another place in another country? The register should communicate between each other. If a person submits his data once in Europe, then that is sufficient, and from there on the register should just communicate with each other. And this has to do with another important aspect in this declaration. In this declaration we state that all the solutions should be user-centric, user-friendly. And here in Estonia all the people know that when the solutions are user-friendly, then they are actually used in practice. But if the solutions are not user-friendly, then it's just a waste of the taxpayers' money and no one starts using the solutions. Once again, I would like to thank everyone for organizing these digital events. Estonia so far has organized its presidency events very well. Thank you. Thank you very much, Mitch. And I will now give the floor to Mr. Siim Sikkut.
Thank you, and I would like to continue with all the congratulations. The fact that we have 32 signatures on this declaration is not an achievement not only for Estonia, but an outcome of the work of officials from all those 32 countries and the European Commission. We have been working on this declaration for a few last months. The aim of putting together this declaration was to bring together member states, because many e-government issues remain on the national level. The last time we met on the e-government issues was during Swedish presidency in 2008. And this means that we need to follow up on European agreements, for example, the e-government action plan on the European level, which lasts until 2020. But we need to look forward into the future, what happens after 2020. When it comes to the implementation of the declaration, then of course we have the European action plan, which is a living document which needs to be updated. Secondly, the Estonian presidency has been very well working together with Bulgaria and Austria, our trio partners, who will continue work on this topic and try to move it forward. And the third, last pillar here is in the court, the ball is in the court of member states, including Estonia. We ourselves have a lot to achieve to carry out the objectives in the declaration. We are actually reviewing our information society strategy in the beginning of next year, and we need to see that those principles remain guiding our own e-government solutions as well. And we have heard a lot of support from ministers this morning to the declaration. They have voiced the support through their signatures as well, but the topics that have already been mentioned today, once only principle, the electronic ID, but also, for example, digital skills and digital leadership skills among officials were topics that were mentioned a lot this morning. So this is a good point of departure, but we need to continue from here. Thank you. Does anyone want to ask something? The speaker does not have a mic, so we can't translate the question.
Kas on mikrofoni? On mikrofoni, muidu ei saa tõlget, et igaks juhuks küsin. Kas meil on mõeldud mikrofonide peale?
Nii, aga kuidas muidu tõlgida saab?
Kohe tuleb tõlgida. Üks moment, vabandust.
There is a mic coming up.
Muidu ei saa.
Aivar Pau, Postimees, Estonian Daily.
Do you have a fixed time frame for the steps that we need to take? Do we have a stock taking as at today? And can we say, so that we could say in 5 years, what would be available then? When could we, for example, buy prescribed routes from Estonia in Brussels? Yes, so we have agreed the time frame of 5 years to carry those things out, says Estonian CEO. And yes, in 5 years' term, we can see how many member states have achieved this objective. To add something, Siim said that the last conference took place 8 years ago during the Swedish presidency. Then. This morning, Austria already said that they would have a high-level e-government conference in Vienna in September 2018. So we will now take a shorter step than those previous 8 years, so we can actually in 1 year's time already look at what has happened meanwhile. So we want to make sure that this goodwill of member states is accompanied by concrete steps, because in a year's time we expect the ministers to say what they have done and what the challenges have been. Yes, and I think the cooperation with the European Commission is also of use here, because Commission calls regularly on member states to meet to look at the developments, and declaration will be a good framework for that. The European Digital Society and Economy Index has actually launched a certain kind of competition between member states. Part of this index actually covers public e-government services, and I think that we have been updating this index component and we will keep updating it. So I think that now that all EU member states are convinced that digital public services need to be offered and need to be also offered in a cross-border manner, I believe that the declaration will also launch another race to delivery. So I'm looking forward to new rating tables, and I hope that all member states in those rating tables will improve their current position quite significantly. Thank you. Does anyone want to ask more questions? If not, then the official part is over. If you wish, you can test out Dominic Escafer's virtual reality solutions.
Dominic,
he will explain what has been said about virtual reality during today's conference. His equipment is available in the corner, and we have also representatives from Creative Estonia Foundation. They have launched the e-government startup competition, and they are also available for your questions.